Good afternoon, and thank you all for joining us today in what could conceivably be the shortest press conference that you've attended in a long time. Again, good afternoon. My name is Ron Schuler. I'm Minister of Infrastructure. And on behalf of Premier Brian Pallister and our government, I want to thank all of you for joining us today. Our government's priority has always been about protecting Manitobans and moving our province forward. We understand that Manitobans need a break, especially during these difficult times. That is why in Budget 2021, we committed to making life more affordable for Manitobans and their families. Today, we are happy to announce that vehicle registration fees will be reduced by a further 10% starting in July. That's keeping $15 million in the pockets of Manitoba drivers. Or that is $15 million more dollars on the kitchen tables of Manitoba families. Combined with last year's 10% reduction, fees have been reduced by 20% in just 2 years. Manitobans will benefit from a $10 decrease to the existing $139 vehicle registration fee as a continued step to reverse the 30% increase of 2012, which was implemented by the previous administration. The registration fee decrease will apply to non-commercial vehicles, resulting in an annual registration fee of $129 for most cars, sport utility vehicles, and light trucks. Owners of other non-commercial vehicles, including motorcycles, mopeds, farm and personal use trucks, and trailers, will also benefit from reduced registration fees of a $3 decrease. Our government will continue to take steps to protect Manitoba incomes. We have committed in Budget 2021 to reduce vehicle registration fees, and we have kept that promise. So thank you very much. I would now like to invite questions.
Thank you, Minister. A reminder to the reporters on the line, you will have one preliminary and one follow-up question. Up first this afternoon from CTV Winnipeg, Danton.
Hi there, Danton Unger, CTV News Winnipeg. So we saw a 10% decrease last year, a 10% decrease this year. Can Manitobans expect another 10% decrease next year to completely reverse that 30% increase?
That is correct. Next year, we will fulfill our commitment to reduce it by 30%, which it had been raised under the previous government. We made that in the last provincial election, and we fully intend on living up to that commitment. So next year will be the final installment.
Wonderful. Thank you for that.
Thank you. Can you
explain why non-commercial vehicles like the motorcycles, farm trucks, that sort of thing, aren't seeing the full 10% decrease as the other vehicles?
Yeah, and that was a commitment that we had made. I mean, this was more for the general fund. These are specific vehicles that are in specific funds. So we had said under the general rate that we were going to reduce, and that's where the increase basically had happened. We also didn't include commercial vehicles for the same reason. We believe that this is something that broadly affects all Manitobans, and we wanted to be very clear that we would impact all Manitobans who are driving their vehicles, use it for whether it's driving to work or whether it's taking their families out to the lake. We wanted to indicate to them that you know, we were going to live up to the commitment we had made. We know that we're in the middle of a pandemic. We know that people are distracted by what's going on with COVID, but still we wanted to live up to the commitment that we had made.
From the Winnipeg Free Press, Carol.
Good afternoon, Minister. With Manitoba still in a pandemic and the province deeply in debt, is it prudent, is now the time to be cutting registration fees?
You know, especially now because people still need their vehicles, they need to drive their vehicles. We know that whether it's taking your family on a drive to a park somewhere or it's driving into work, we appreciate that Manitobans are struggling And this is, again, recognizing, first of all, that we had made a commitment. We did run on this commitment. We said we were going to do it. And we are a government that lives up to the commitments we made. We did it on the PSD. We're doing it on the property tax reduction. You know, all the things that we said we were going to do, we are doing, Carol. And this is one of those. It is a $15 million benefit to Manitobans. We think that is significant. Maybe not everybody will find it as significant as some families that do live from paycheck to paycheck. We think now is the time to give relief. We know that vaccination rates are going up. As we get the vaccines, we're putting them out there. Once we get to a certain point, we want to give Manitobans a lot of hope that we can hopefully get ourselves back to some kind of a normal. And we hope that this announcement also gives Manitobans a little bit more hope. And $15 million to some, spread across Manitoba, we think that it's significant. And it indicates, again, that our government understands that Manitobans, many Manitobans, are struggling. We think now is a very good time for it.
Okay, but that's not a very large amount. I mean, it's not going to, give anyone a great deal of relief individually. So I'm just thinking about the amount of money that the province owes and how much it's giving back to individual vehicle owners. It doesn't seem like it's much of a big deal. Is it just a psychological kind of reward? I mean, you said people are living paycheck to paycheck, but this would work out to be like $12 or $13 per vehicle, unless my math is wrong.
Yeah, and Carol, we also believe that tone and message matters. And we've had a lot of very tough messages come in the last year and a half on the COVID side. And there has to be a time when we start to give hope back to individuals, and that you've got a government that is there. And frankly, within the Department of Manitoba Infrastructure, we keep going. We are going to be spending $630 million on infrastructure this year. We're going to keep going. We believe we are the Department of Hope. We are the Department of the Day After Tomorrow, that when we come out of this, there will be something there for Manitobans to look forward to. Is this symbolism? Well, it's very positive symbolism, and it sets a tone that you have a government, number one, that committed to do this, that ran on it, that said they were going to do it and lived up to that commitment. And secondly, we recognize that although it may not be the biggest benefit to Manitobans, that it still is something. When it was a 30% increase, that was significant to some individuals. Now it's going to be a 30% decrease. That is significant to some individuals. And again, we made the commitment, and we're living up to that commitment.
From the Brandon Sun, Colin.
Good afternoon, Minister. How much money or how much revenue is the province expecting to lose out on because of this fee decrease?
Well, it's a $15 million reduction. So it would be a $15 million reduction in revenues. We are seeing every year increasing more vehicles that are being registered. So we actually see an increase in revenue when it comes to registration fees. So we don't view this as being a big financial hardship for government or that it's going to significantly impact the finances of the province. However, Colin, we did make this commitment and we said we were going to do it. And we're doing it. And we're living up to that commitment as we did on the property tax increase or property tax decrease, taking education property taxes off of property. We've lived up to that. I remember when we ran in the first election where we formed government, I had a lot of people say to me, we know you're going to say you're going to reduce the PST. We don't think you're ever going to do that. And we did it. And it was the right thing to do. And Manitobans were pleased with that. I think it's important for politicians to make a commitment. Our premier has run on various platforms, and the premier and our government have lived up to those commitments. So is it positive symbolism? Absolutely. It's a $15 million reduction. It's not the biggest reduction. It probably pales in comparison to the education taxes coming off of property, but it is important. And it is important because it's a three-year plan, and we are living up to our commitment. And yes, it does impact some families substantially, who, you know, having a car is in this era is very important, especially if you want to go grocery shopping, that kind of stuff. We've got some very good active transportation corridors. We've got some very good bus service. But sometimes you do need a vehicle, and families need these vehicles. So we think this is positive. We think it's important to do it now. And it it sends a very positive message.
Last year, there were a couple of instances where non-commercial vehicle owners were given some relief through MPI rebates. Are there any plans to do one or more similar rebates this year with the pandemic still ongoing?
Yeah, Colin, today's announcement is about something that we had committed to during the last provincial election and that we're living up to it. That question would probably be best for Minister Wharton to answer. That is his department. I wouldn't know what the plans are there. I'll leave that up to him to answer that question. All I know is that in this particular instance, this is something that we think is important. It's important to announce right now. We think it sends a good tone, it sends a good message. And today's announcement is about this reduction that we committed to and we're doing.
Our final reporter this afternoon from CJOB, Skyler.
Hi, Minister Schuler. Thanks for the time this afternoon. Just wondering if you can give us an update on negotiations with auto body shops and MPI. We know they're still kind of at an impasse, and it looks like the auto body shops want the province to step up to the table with an independent arbitrator. Is that going to happen?
And again, Skyler, I am Minister of Infrastructure, and this particular announcement falls under my department. So I'm going to actually leave my comments basically on this particular topic. You would have to speak to Minister Wharton about that. I can say that negotiations are ongoing and they continue on. This is between the corporation and between some of their service providers, and probably should leave it there. And perhaps you would want to speak to Minister Wharton for more of the details. And as always, Skyler, great to hear from you again. I don't know why you don't have me on your radio station anymore. I'm still here. All the rest of you, you know, you guys could call me. I feel a little lonely up on the second floor. I know we're the Department of Good News. $630 million we're going to spend on our highways and roads. And it's the biggest commitment ever made in the history of this province. And this $15 million is just another great news story. So, Skyler, you should probably speak to Minister Wharton. It's not my department.
Well, it's your lucky day, Minister Schuler. I've got an 8:30 time slot Sunday morning. I'm filling in on the weekend show, so we'll talk about that. I'll send you an email. This one's more up your alley, though. Just wondering if you can give us an update on the interchange progress at St. Mary's Road. Has the province decided on a final design or a final contractor for that? You know, the bid process was ongoing last time we heard from you.
That is correct. That is ongoing. So we narrowed the field. We did the RFP for qualifiers, and we had three companies that qualified, and now they're putting together a bid. We hope to be making an announcement soon. In the meantime, there's a lot of work going on. I don't know if you had a chance to go through that intersection. There's a lot of work going on prepping the site, getting ready for the bridge to move. I don't know if you've had a chance to see the bridge over the floodway on the north on the North Floodway on 59 North. And just amazing how quickly, once we get going, how quickly you'll see that bridge starting to go up. We think that's an incredibly exciting project. And we would like to see the tenders come in. And again, that's an arm's length process. I have no say in that process. I have no politician, no government official from our government has any say in that process. It is done internally by professionals within Manitoba Infrastructure, and other departments are involved in that. So I don't know exactly where it's at, because again, I'm not at the table and neither should I be. There are individuals that are better qualified than I to make those decisions. Plus it takes the whole political side of it out of it. As soon as we have something to announce, we will be announcing it. And this is particularly exciting for myself. As you know, the perimeter is a big project. We hope that maybe by fall we'll be able to come out in front of you again and announce that all crossovers have been removed. And hopefully within time we can talk about all uncontrolled access points on the perimeter have been removed. And, you know, the St. Mary's Bridge is sort of the recognition that the perimeter highway should be viewed eventually as a freeway corridor. And that's very important. I think it's psychological for Winnipeg and for Manitoba to have our first freeway status, a perimeter highway, and St. Mary's Bridge is sort of the kickoff to get our way there. So a lot of exciting stuff happening there. And, you know, if you want to, you know, bring me on your, you said it was at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning, which is the way I heard it. I'd be more than willing to be on your show at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning. That would be a really good time slot.
Thank you, Minister. This concludes our media briefing.
Thank you all for being here. Appreciate it.